it's been a ride. I love being the mayor because I have such a good time up here. Las Vegas is a tale of two cities. It's a very interesting place. We have about 2 million people who live here on a permanent basis in our valley. And we yearn and thirst for the same things that people in other cities do: great culture, great medicine, great art, great sports. And then we have the other city, which is our entertainment capital of the world, where we have the best of the shows, great entertainment, best food, best retail boutique shopping, most beautiful hotels. So I'm often asked, what's next for Las Vegas? And it's only the limitation of the human mind. There's going to be somebody who's going to be able to figure out something different than any other place. I always envision what it would be like if, God forbid, there'd be a natural disaster and the archaeologists come in here in years to come, and they'll see the rubble of France, they'll see the rubble of Rome, they'll see even Star Trek. And archaeologists would never be able to figure out what was here because they would be baffled. The human mind is an amazing thing, and that's what has made Las Vegas what it is. Our slogan in Las Vegas is, what happens here stays here. When I was first elected, it's 10 years ago now, I was a member and now I'm the chair of our Las Vegas Visitors and Convention Authority, and we had an advertising campaign at that time which was designed to attract family folks, children, and I said to myself, if they want to bring kids here, which is it's a nice place to bring the youngsters here, but really that's not what Las Vegas is all about. This is an adult playland, so we directed our advertising agency to come up with a mark or a slogan. That's when we decided upon what happens here stays here. It's been phenomenally successful. As a matter of fact, Las Vegas is the second most recognized brand in the world. Only Google is recognized more than Las Vegas. Everybody who comes to see me has to bring me a gift. I mean, the public knows that. I will not talk to any constituent unless they come bearing gifts. And wherever you look, there's something a little different. I've got my neon sign here with my signature on it, with my beautiful showgirls, where I will go no place without. The showgirls are beautiful and they sparkle and they're like neon, so that's the image that we're trying to project. This was given to me when I was first elected. It was covered with red paint. And because I have children up here all the time, I had to take my wife's nail polish remover and take the paint off so it doesn't scare anybody. This picture over here was by an artist who comes from the Caribbean. I have about, I'd say, 30 portraits of wonderful artists who have done pictures of me. Okay, and this is my my throne. I think I'm the only mayor who has a throne. If there's any other, I haven't seen it. And we have all these interesting little odds and ends, mementos of being the mayor of the greatest city and being the happiest mayor in the universe.